What country's capital is growing the fastest? Ireland. Because every day is Dublin. I'll let that sink in. Welcome to Mafia 2 Definitive Edition again. Obviously, they're all gonna be definitive, I think. Even the third one. I was expecting some sort of continuation, or I am expecting some sort of continuation from the previous game to this one. I'm not even sure if it's gonna have any connection to Tommy or not. It could be completely different family in different city, stuff like that. I would have hoped that things wouldn't have ended the way they did in the previous one. The only person I would have liked to be killed was the Don. It's always the case, I feel like. But yeah, I'm excited to see what this brings. You guys hyped me up a lot for this game, so it better be even better than the first one, because the first one's story was cliche-ish, but amazing at the same time. So, let's get into it. Okay, so we have the option to do additional content as well. Obviously, the betrayal of Jimmy and whatever else it says there. I'm not gonna go into them because it's probably spoilers. Somebody probably betrays Jimmy and Jimmy's the main protagonist, so I presume I already got spoiled anyway. But that's the case in every gangster, mafia, mobster, movie, game, whatever you might call it, okay? So nothing shocking there. I'm gonna play on medium because I did on the last one, so. Presents the game's narrative content in its original form from 2010. The game includes culturally sensitive content and themes and is intended only for a mature audience. Perfect. I wish I wasn't mature, but I'm too mature, I think. That sounds weird. Okay, the guy wants too much something. Right, here we go. I already love the 2K and hangar guy, so it's check. Oh, okay. Oh, actually, I think one of you guys mentioned it to me. Sorry for my screeching. Chair. Here's what it is. I need a bit of WD-40 or something. Let's go, Mafia 2.
My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. From Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare.
Oh, wow.
My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work. And what little money he made mostly went towards booze.
Oh.
Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around...
Oh, shit.
You started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop! Mina, this way! Throw me to bed! Stop! I'm gonna shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry, Vito. Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war.
Yeah.
And the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18.
Oh.
And anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Can I just ask, why does this look worse than the first game? Did they not remaster both of them? Or remake or whatever?
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily. But we got hit by flak and had to bail out. Way behind enemy lines.
Reminds me of Call of Duty 2.
If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance.
Yes, I played all
so
of them.
Most of the soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up. We decided to return to fit.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
Okay.
All right, Scaletta.
Allora,
take the
traditori.
Okay.
Dovevi incassare il ferito. Shit!
Attenda!
Oh shit! Out of the way, okay? Okay.
This guy's saying there's more troops headed this way.
Okay, can we just... Game setting... Subtitles on, just because.
Alright. You and William take
out
MG, then find
the
prisoner. We're gonna need every man we can get.
Okay. This seems to be a game that hasn't been done to... you know, anything to at all.
We found the machine gun! Watch it! You got a grenade, Scaletta. This would be a great fucking time to use it! Put a grenade through the window!
Okay. Whoa!
Whoa!
Okay, I guess that's meant to happen. Since we didn't die.
Scaletta, you alive?
Yeah, just about.
Well, then get off your ass and let's move.
Grab all the ammo you can carry. This might be our last chance.
I don't know what I'm picking up. There we go. I'm picking up whatever I can find. Okay. Oh, hi. Sorry.
On the stairs!
Hey, please go.
Whoa! Whoa, okay. She's out of cooking! Get him!
Must
okay.
have the prisoners upstairs. Clear the second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
Uccidete gli ostaggi!
Oh! I didn't realize you were here as well. Shit. Oh my god. The controls are a bit... I'm not used to them, okay? It's gonna take a bit of getting used to.
Arrenditi, o gli faccio saltare il sacco.
Oh shoot.
Shit. Looks like we're going this way.
Okay.
Come on.
I feel like it's too close to the camera. I can't fucking see.
Get some fuck, it's good show. What the hell do you look like, Apu?
I feel like I'm gonna die here. Ah! Then go. Fuck hell. Use the MG and defend the Town Hall, okay.
See that gun on the balcony, Skeletta?
No.
Get on it!
Oh, right.
If these guys get inside, we're fucked!
Come on! I am pressing it. Jesus, I'm coming.
Take out that truck!
The truck, he said, right? Die here. Okay, how do I exit this? It is weird compared to the previous one, I have to say, guys.
Dicevo al mio amico di stare
attento. Oh no, they got us?
Pregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
The fascist! Why is this hard to pronounce? Fascist? I can't pronounce it. Fascist.
Che diavolo sta dicendo? Chi si crede di essere?
Fine.
Un'offerta da fare!
Sei davvero Don Cao?
Cacetto. Un congè quando siamo arretati come cuscino.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noiacci del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to.
Imagine to have that power. Is this like based on true events? Because that would be pretty amazing, to be honest, if that actually happened. It's probably all fictional, let's be real. Oh, I didn't get a chance to read. Okay, home sweet home. Here we go. 2 years later, Empire Barry, February 8th. 45, so the war kind of ended, right? Or is about to end. I'm not sure what month it ended in. I know it's 45, but I'm not sure what month. I want to say it's like summertime, but could be wrong.
A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
That's his friend. Is he waiting for him? I would imagine.
Vito!
How is he gonna
react,
though?
Joe!
Hey!
Oh, he's happy, okay.
Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
Probably joined a mobster crew or something. Okay.
There it is. Empire Bay.
Do I drive?
Tell the truth. You miss it?
No. Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry though, a drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito, come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes, we're already talking about my deadbeat father.
Huh.
Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal. What was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading?
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit. Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. Ah. Old country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Here's to Dant.
Salud.
Salud. Chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Oh, he's gonna sort us out, or what? Working
for the Yankee Dollar. Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is... Vito Scaletta.
Does this have salacious content in it? Like the other one?
Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
Huh?
What?
Did
you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
What am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Como no frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you want a ride?
No, thanks. I want to walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
Okay,
no problem.
Here we go. Tutorial.
Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Who is she? She looks like one of the prostitutes that just hang around, you know, clubs and bars. I mean, this is like a now thing, so I don't know back in the day if that was the case. Yep. I mean, you had taxis before. Copyright music,
are.
Please.
Oh, thanks.
No!
But the fire is so delightful. And since we've no...
Okay, guys, I had to turn the music off. Copy
hey, what's the strike good word?
Stuff, because it's like
how you
really
doing,
copy
soldier?
Striked. Okay, so you can eat now, I guess. Walk to your mother's. That is me.
Yeah, we'll be right back. Forget it, you two. He's not going anywhere. It's just one lousy beer.
Crazy broad.
That's what he said the last time. Okay, so people seem to know me or, you know, recognize me. Oh gosh, I can't believe. I guess that's why they probably put in free roam in the previous one, just for people to explore. Vito, is that you? Ah! What the? Is this where I have to go? Okay. Go upstairs to Mama's apartment. Here I come, Mama.
Hi, Mama.
Oh, Scarlett.
I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going
and
on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
Sit down, sit down. You must be hungry, Vito.
So where's his father,
Francesca
though?
Made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good
chicken
for
soup.
You. I love chicken soup.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this.
Oh, he
would
died.
He's so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, la mangiata, la porta volontà. Siamo uccellini, provvide nel cuore vicino di noi.
I've never been. I mean, my family, my grandma and stuff were very religious.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
But we never said grace at dinners and stuff like that. I just think that's weird. But I guess if you grow up like that, then it's not great. So no talking. I guess they talked and we just didn't see. Use the bed.
I'll see you two in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
Mio bambino. The next day.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
You need your own place for sure. How old is he now? 21 or something? Oh, get dressed. Sorry. I need to start reading stuff. Mafia pinstriped suit. Mafia 3 combat jacket? What? Okay, let's go with the leather jacket and stuff. Just because. I can't even see his trousers, but yeah, he has trousers.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly. No. Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him. Work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
Okay. Pretty sure he probably won't do that, but, okay. See you later, Ma. Gosh, so many doors here. What was that? Everybody shutting their doors in front of my face because they're afraid or what? I have to say the camera angle is just a bit tripping me out.
I'm sorry.
I don't care if you gotta sell everything you got.
Oh, it's Francesca.
What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business, asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Uh-oh.
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
No, please. Hold. One, two, three. One, two. Come on, then. One, two, three.
Stop, please, Vito. What are you doing?
Teach the city a lesson.
Please, Vito, this isn't your problem.
Okay.
You'll get yourself into more trouble, Vito.
Whoa, blood everywhere.
Ah, fuck this.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here. This. You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Oh yeah, I bet he could. He does seem like he's into slimy business. Oh, that's crouching. What does this do? Nothing really. Oh, L1 to sprint. Okay, because I was pressing L3. I guess we can steal cars. I would imagine why not, you know? How far away is this place? Like, can I see the map? Oh, it's literally around the corner here. It's around the corner! Please don't kill me with your car. Oh, look, you can't even see his footprints. Okay, so I don't know. Did they actually remaster this? Or is this just a 2010 game? because it definitely feels to me like it's a 2010 game. I'm not gonna lie. Wait, is this the... Is this where I have to go? Oh yeah, the arrow is pointing up. Even higher up, should be on this level.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
There we are.
Is this a bad time?
Nah, we ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting for you.
Oh.
All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business.
Okay.
Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
Oh,
the fun's
yeah.
Over, baby. Later, I said. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. Hmm. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
Okay. Here we go.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set. Cause you know me.
Look at this. You got your own phone.
Yeah, and now you do too. Can't do business without... So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were going to introduce me to that guy, Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know,
you can turn off the lights, though.
When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was going to do when you got back?
No, not really. Well,
oh, cool.
Besides the usual, you know, find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's going to be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm going to make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Giuseppe. Okay. So I feel like this is definitely more salacious than that previous one, just because in the previous one you barely, like, you heard some noises in that brothel and then you saw this woman. But she had, like, garments on, so
hey,
I don't think so.
You think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You're gonna let me drive over.
All right. Here's the keys.
All right. Just be fucking careful.
All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe.
I wonder if the physics are actually good on this. Will
okay,
you like
now make a right
skid?
Here. Then just go straight for a while.
Not really. Oh, for goodness sake. How do I stop? Radio off. There we go. Goodness me, the music!
Hey, whoa. Slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason. Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
Oh. And, So what do we do? Okay. I love that this game has copywritten music and it's like Christmas
copywritten
music.
You know you wasn't kidding?
Music.
They really taught
you
to
drive. Sorry, I can't leave it.
At least something good come out of it.
You know the deal. Oh, that's a cop car? Okay. Where do I park? Oh, okay. Cutscene, I guess.
Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Well, are we just gonna take it?
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window.
Okay.
You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's.
Right. So this is kind of like the hub? Where you get stuff at
Welcome
Giuseppe's?
Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off.
Right. Here we are.
Hey, Giuseppe, I brought you a new custom.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
Retired,
Bay.
Retired, please. How are you?
Wait!
Yeah, they are. You got
him finished
We did
a mission
already?
With him!
Yes, for sure, they're done.
Didn't we?
Thanks. This really gonna work?
Wasn't
Nobody
his name Giuseppe?
I would bother you again.
In the previous
Trust
game. The guy that came to
what
help us with the safe.
Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
I actually think it is.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Okay, what else does he have? I can't even check. Okay, lockpicks. Got it. Leave.
Grazie. But you can test it right now. Here. Take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock she opens. Easy.
Oh, I see. To move the pin when in position, press. Oh, so it has to be green? Okay. I see. Nope. No, oh, fuck goodness sake! Okay.
See,
it's not that bad,
Giuseppe,
actually.
Giuseppe,
just have to take your time.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry. You'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car.
Oh, yeah. I remember that was a thing. Is it still... I guess there is still a thing. Some cars you still have to... or not still have to, but you lock them by accident.
Okay. You still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Hold to pick lock. Got it. Easy.
Possible stolen vehicle.
Oh, really? How the frick did
Step
they just...
on it.
Copy that. Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
No, it's not over yet. Lose him. Quick.
Okay. This vehicle is
Roger
going to
that.
Bat the police. Okay. Buzzer took a monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. Okay, drives nice, I have to say. Do you put gas in cars as well? Is that a thing? I'm not sure where I'm going, but I'm just trying to lose this cop car on my back. On my behind. I'm just gonna go straight ahead.
Alright, looks like
nice.
We lost. So how do you like the car?
Not too
cool.
Bad. I think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey,
oh,
that
yeah.
Don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs it.
Don't you worry. Oh, police. Straighten up and fly right. Why are they on my back? Why are they on my back? Because of my this vehicle. Oh, so it's still wanted because of that. Oh my god, okay. Can I not go? Okay. I have to go around, I guess. Shit. Hit. Let's hope there's no more police around. There's a lot more stuff in this, for sure. Like, telephones and a lot more stuff that you could do. Oh my god. What did I just say? I just said about the police vehicle. Told the monkey you are choking me
really
Okay, here we are, you guys. Body shop, get out.
What's going on?
Oh, the police was literally on our behind.
What can I do you for, pal?
Change the plates.
Okay. Plate. For you, no problem.
Okay, a personalized. Okay, just OPQR. I just want to put AJ. Oh no. Okay, never mind. I don't care. Change color.
Any color.
Ooh. Seafoam green? I don't know. Fennel, actually. Buttermilk. Okay, I only have two. Okay.
Be done in a jiffy.
Improve engine. Your car is fully tuned.
Bring it by
okay.
Anytime.
Cool. So I always have to do this. Change the plate and the color, probably just to. For the police not to want
all right,
it anymore.
Next,
I would
you should
imagine.
Introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He probably have some work for you.
Okay. Right,
where is
he? He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss it.
Right. Okay.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters.
Okie dokie.
Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I could see myself in your pants.
Oh, God. Who would fall for that? Who would fall for that, though?
Here, I got another one.
Oh, yeah.
If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
That's a good one, actually. You and I together.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
And this works for you. Does it now?
Oh,
does
here's
it?
A good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
You got problems, you know that? Oh my god, I think I'm going a bit too fast.
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? Give me the door and I'll slam you.
Oh my god.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift?
I don't get your drift, but whatever you say. Sorry.
That's Mike's junkyard there. Just drive through the gate.
Okay, through the gate, I'm driving. It's quite interesting. At least we see something different other than buildings. Like we did in the previous one, even though I really like the previous one. I don't know, you guys, I just...
Hey, look who's here.
Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you could wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know? Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruski. But don't shake his hand. He ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Right.
Got it.
God damn it, Mike. You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs
Jesus
these days.
Christ.
And who knows if they can even get this filled
you
out.
You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
400.
All right, deal.
Alfredo, come on, let's go. Andiamo. Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Oh, God.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, eh?
I'll do my best.
Take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out.
Okay.
Here you go.
Tutorial again,
I guess. For that old wreck over there.
Okay. Shoot the tires. How?
Hey, you ain't a bad shot.
I see.
Hey, Vito, see if you could hit the gas tank.
I don't know. Is this the gas tank? That's the gas tank, right? No. I don't have any more stuff, you guys. Get ammo.
Hey, I need some more ammo.
Of course you do. Here you go.
Shoot the car's gas tank to finish. Okay, so in my opinion, I thought that was the engine. Is that the gas tank?
Shit. Did I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Pollock joke there, but I'll leave it alone.
Oh, duh. Yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
All right, that's enough shooting. We got work to do.
Right. Okay. Where do we go? Oh, we get in the car? Drive to the Lone Star Bar with Joe. Okay. I guess I'm not really done with the tutorials. Oh. But I probably will be. So in Romania, if it snows and if it's snowy and icy,
all right, go
like
out the
this
way we came in and get on the main highway going west. Don't go back through the city.
Okay. I switched the radio music off because it's all copywritten, so I don't want to get a copy strike. Yeah, so in Romania, you put actual chains
right up here
on your wheels.
So
they don't slide.
How's it feel to be back?
Good. Feel a
that's
lot
how bad
better
it gets
with
there.
Money in my pocket.
Hey, what's the rush? Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Get the fuck
it does.
Out of here.
Nah, I was just fucking with you. Don't worry about the money. This little job is just the beginning. Pretty soon you'll be rolling in it.
So, Sand Island's still the same shithole it was when I left?
No, the place actually ain't too bad now.
Oh, shit. How the hell that happen?
All the moolies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole, Vito.
Nah.
You've only been gone a couple of years. Gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply like rabbits. What are you gonna do? It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there now. What's their fucking name? The Beamers, the Boomers, something like that.
Oh,
I don't
wow
fucking know.
Oh, that's just fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope and kill each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you. And even if they do, that's why I gave you that pistol.
Oh, by the way, you're carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Can't do business without it these days. Especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, really know how to inspire confidence, you know that? Well, I forgot how nice this neighborhood was. You know something? One of these days, I'm gonna buy a house here.
Look at this guy.
He
ain't even back
a
day
well
and he's too good for his old neighborhood.
Hey, what are you breaking my balls for? I'm just window shopping. It'll be years before I could afford a place like this.
Decades,
you got
maybe
champagne tastes and beer pockets, my friend. Don't worry, though. I'm gonna help you change that.
Okay, well, we're definitely counting on it. God. But this is such a common mistake that people that get out of prison or get out of, like, prison war in his case, right? That they end up going back and reverting to their old ways because, oh, I just passed where I'm supposed to go, what a dickhead. I had this in my family as well happen. People just don't seem to learn their
it's
lesson.
It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
What if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
Okay. First attempt. Steal the cream colored. Okay. there's people here. There's this guy. Press to climb over obstacle. Can I go through this? Wait. Oh, this is the beer. I don't think there would be a door. There is a door that leads back. Hold on. I might be able to do this, guys. Or no? Yeah, I think so.
Hey, what the fuck are you doing over there?
Oh, I!
Ah, shit.
Okay, I didn't dodge. Oh, shit. God, it just takes so long to just knock a guy out, you know what I mean? Here we go, I guess.
Hey!
You saw me.
Hey, what you doing, motherfucker?
Motherfucker! Get in the car. Use wrench!
Damn it.
Oh, shoot. Never mind, I got it. Okay, come on. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna watch me. Fuck yeah. They're probably gonna come chasing after me. Bombers? Is that what they're called? I think these are obviously the guys that what's his name mentioned? Right, they are definitely sorry. Coming behind me in full force. Sorry. Oh my god, please don't show me. I'm like barely escaping with my dear life. This is a nice neighborhood. We shouldn't shoot in the nice neighborhood. We're gonna lose them eventually. I just don't know when. Right, I need to. Okay, the brakes work quite nicely here. Oh! Fuck! Please don't come after me. Oh my god. Why? Oh my god. By the time I get this car back, it's gonna be absolute rubbish. They're still after my behind. I could have cut it in this square thing, to be honest. Could have gone and cut the corner, I mean. Okay, it's very slippy slidey. Out of my way, buddy. Out of my way, a businessman is coming. He done his first goddamn business. Wow. Gosh. I wonder if this whole game is... Oh my god. What the... did that guy just fall? Did I ever tell you guys one time it was really bad snowing back in Romania. I went to get my eyebrows threaded and done. Whatever. I think I was 18. And I was walking in the park and some fucking dickhead kids decided to make like a slide on the pathway. So like you basically, it's so cold that the water freezes if you chuck it on the street. And they made a slide. And because it snowed on top of it and I didn't realize it was a slide there, I fell. Thank God I had a hat on, like a thick furry hat. I fell, hit my head on the back and literally like... fell on my back and hit my head, and I think I was unconscious for a few seconds. I'm not even joking. I shouldn't laugh, but when I woke up, I was just not woke up because I think I was still there, but I think I was either in shock or suffered like a minor concussion.
Hey,
I was just lying there like that. Nobody
go?
Around. Yeah, imagine if I would have died. Nobody was around in that park.
They tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunt is their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Oh, nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I'd give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like you, buddy Joe. Here's your 400 bucks.
Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. See you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman.
300.
Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
Okay.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted.
Right, let's drive home then. But yeah, obviously I'm exaggerating. I could have died. I don't really think I could have died. Thank God for the hat, because otherwise I literally hit my head on the pavement, on the hard pavement. So it could have definitely turned out badly, but it didn't. So I'm cool with that, you know. But that's like as traumatic as my life gets. Well, not really. I had other shit happen to me that I am never gonna talk about. Probably in my life, not online anyway.
We should take the highway.
People that are close to me know. But yeah, I don't like talking about personal stuff.
Pulled off that job without fucking it up. Nice going.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked.
But if it's funny,
I'll live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
I guess you're right.
Don't worry about it. It's all gonna be a piece of cake.
Don't worry about it. Ooh, almost missed my turn.
So, what's the story with Bruski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scam going. He deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay to clean bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time we was at the track, and some mitt spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye.
Oh, my.
A lousy $10. You believe that shit?
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just gotta know how to handle these people. And Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I met since you shipped out.
Hey, is there a safe place to park around here? I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage.
Right,
the streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
I should have waited to see the frick the whole conversation. Get out, park in the garage. Okay. I hate that you honk every time. Every time you have to get something, you press square and it honks as well. They should have pressed honk on a different one. Do I go in first? Okay. Where's the stairs? There? No. Here? Yeah. I'm actually not exactly sure where his apartment is. It's not this one, is it? I think it's one up. Is it one up? I feel like it was here. No? Well, take me to your fucking place, guy! Okay, was it another one up? No. Okay, I'm so confused, you guys. Am I in the right place as well? Okay, I guess this is it. Yeah, I'll take some food.
You're hungry, Vito? Take
whatever
you want from the
Where's
fridge.
The fucking fridge? Okay. It's got a nice place. Not too shabby. Oh, wow. Swift Cola sandwiches. There we go. Take food. Eating and drinking heals. Okay, of course. Just like in GTA, I guess. Your health has to replenish maximum. Crash on the kitchen couch to get some sleep. Okay. Cool. I didn't even see my health, to be honest. Chapter 3. Enemy of the state. Joe's apartment, February 10th, 1945. I didn't mean to do that. I will leave it here for this episode just because I don't want it to be too long. So I think we kind of did the tutorial bit, so now we know what to do. I'm pretty sure we're going to find out some more or have some more jobs available to us soon. But yeah, that's it for this episode. Hope you guys are excited for me to play it. I am. The map is not very big. I would imagine that's all there is. Compared to the first one, this is quite small, right? I don't know if you unlock more of it progressively or not, but that's where we're at. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.